Amazon published EKS Best Practices Guide a while ago, where you can learn how to properly set up and manage EKS clusters in production. This guide includes chapters that cover security, reliability, autoscaling, networking, and scalability. Harden EKS is also a tool created by Amazon that programmatically validates if your cluster follows the best practices covered in this guide. EKS Best Practice Guide is very detailed and contains a lot of information on how to best run and secure Amazon EKS cluster. You should definitely study this guide. Meanwhile, this tool serves as a quick checklist. You can use it every now and then to check that your clusters are up to date and secure. Unlike many other tools and add-ons for EKS cluster, Harden EKS is designed to run externally. This means you don't have to install it in the cluster, which reduces the number of components you have to maintain in Kubernetes. Harden EKS is a Python application you can install with pip package manager and run it from your own laptop. You can even set up a cron job to run it periodically and send alerts to Slack, for example, if it detects a drift in one of your clusters. Before we can run the demo, let me quickly go over Terraform code I prepared to create VPC and EKS cluster from scratch. We start by setting up AWS provider with version constraints. Next, I use open source VPC Terraform module to create a private virtual network in our account with labels made specifically for the EKS cluster. I also have in-depth guides on using Terraform and TerraGround for deploying and managing EKS clusters available on my channel. Then I use another open source module to create EKS cluster itself. Important thing to notice here is the cluster name, and I have also enabled a public endpoint because we don't have a VPN or a Bastion host in AWS. At the end, I deploy EBS driver to allow us to run stateful applications in the EKS cluster. This EKS module also sets up OpenID Connect provider by default, which we can use to allow this CSI driver to access EBS volumes. And I deploy it as a managed EKS add-on. To provision infrastructure, we first need to initialize Terraform and then run apply command. It usually takes around 20 minutes to set up EKS cluster and EBS driver. Next, we need to update the local Kubernetes context so we can access the cluster and do a quick check to make sure that we connected. Finally, we'll set up a storage class based on the EBS provisioner we just deployed. Let's go ahead and apply this as well. Now, you can find Harden EKS project on GitHub. When you scroll down, you'll come across directions on how to set it up and command line options you can use. For example, we'll have to provide a region and EKS cluster name. It's crucial to understand that Harden EKS requires access not just to your Kubernetes cluster for running checks, but also to your AWS account. For instance, it needs to verify if VPC flow logs are enabled. To achieve this, you'll have to add certain IAM policies to your IAM user or IAM role you're using. I've been using the admin role, so I already have all the permissions necessary. Now, let's proceed with the installation. Ideally, to keep your Python environment separate, you should first set up a virtual environment. After that, you need to activate it and install the Harden EKS pip package. This is a straightforward process, just ensure that you have already installed Python. Let's run the help first to make sure that the tool has been properly installed. You'll see the same command line arguments that were on GitHub page here. A few handy ones include exporting results in JSON format, which can be useful if you want to integrate this tool with others, like for sending alert. Working with JSON is much simpler than parsing a text. Next, let's run a test. We need to specify the region where we set up EKS cluster and provide the cluster name. I also want to export the results in HTML format because it includes links to a guide on best practices. The test will take a few seconds, so be patient. It's also crucial to note that it utilizes the default configuration that comes with the tool, but we'll override it later. Alright, we have our results. Hardan EKS will list all its rules, which currently number over 40, and mark any failed tests in red. For instance, under reliability rules, you'll see it pointed out that we lack a metric server and vertical pod autoscaler. It also notes that the storage class we set up doesn't use encryption. Plus, there are other issues it detected that you'll need to address. Since we asked for HTML report, let's open it as well. This report is essentially the same, but now you can click on the links to learn more about each issue. Personally, I think this is the best part of this tool, as it not only highlights the problem, but also explains why it's a best practice. For instance, if you click on the link related to the storage class, you'll find details on why you need to use encryption and how to do it. Now, let's go ahead and address some of these issues. Firstly, let's deploy a metric server to our cluster. I prefer to use Terraform with a Helm provider to install some system components that don't need a lot of maintenance. In Terraform, we first need to get some information about existing cluster and initialize the Helm provider. Then we can use Helm release Terraform resource to deploy the metric server to EKS. As of now, its most recent version. Let's initialize again to download the Helm provider and apply it to deploy the metric server to Kubernetes. To make sure it was installed correctly, we can run kubectl top pods command. This will show you the CPU and memory usage in kubesystem namespace. If it fails and reports that metrics API is not available, you'll need to check the deployment. Now let's run the tests again. You'll notice that the metric server is now marked in green. As I mentioned before, you can generate a report in JSON format. Let's run the test again and open the report.json file. Every rule will have a status property, which either true, indicating you following the best practices, or false. You could use another script to parse only rules with a false status and send alerts. Next, let's fix the storage class issue. It's simple, just send encryption property to true in the storage class. Since it's immutable object, we need to delete it first and then recreate it. Alright, it's done. Now we can run the tests. If you scroll all the way up, you'll see that the storage class issue has been resolved. To confirm that the encryption is functioning correctly, we can deploy a stateful set using our new storage class named MyGP3. Then apply the stateful set. Now give it a few seconds until the pod is up and running. In the AWS console, navigate to Volumes section under EC2 dashboard. Select the volume that was attached to the pod. You'll see that this volume uses encryption. Let's run Hardan EKS once more and generate HTML report. It's important to note that some of these issues are controversial and you shouldn't blindly follow the test results. For instance, this tool suggests that you should enable VPC flow logs. While it can be useful for debugging, it can be also crazy expensive. Therefore, I would recommend assessing your existing environment and determining what's best for your specific situation. Another example would be the vertical pod autoscaler. It's not recommended to run both the horizontal and vertical pod autoscalers simultaneously. Also, providing recommendations for stateless applications can often be unhelpful. For instance, if you get a vertical pod autoscaler recommendation when running 2 replicas, the advice would be drastically different if you're running 10 replicas. There are some edge cases, such as running database-oriented stateful applications in Kubernetes or stateless applications that are constrained by the number of partitions in Kafka topic. So what I'm trying to say is that if you intentionally decided not to follow some best practices, you wouldn't want to see tests failing because of those choices. The way to disable them is to create custom configuration. You can find the default Harden EKS config in the GitHub project. Let's copy it and paste it to our project. Now we can either remove some tests or simply comment them out. You can also choose to ignore the namespaces. If you don't use the default namespace, you can add it here as well. Let's go ahead and disable the flow logs rule and also turn off the vertical pod autoscaler. That's pretty much it. When you run the tests, you just need to include a config argument that points to your custom configuration file. After this, you won't see those rules in the report. I have more EKS tutorials on my channel that you might find interesting. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.